Hi, I'm Patty Harrison.
Huge bitch, and I'm Joel Kim Booster.
And you're watching Unsend, where we celebrate the best and the worst of the web, but mostly the worst.
Listen, it's time to tackle a hard-hitting issue that rubs each and every one of us the wrong way. I'm not talking about ISIS. I'm talking about Instagram ads.
Ugh, the worst. Yay, ISIS.
Look, we're going to Instagram to gawk at shapely male bodies and to find out what our ex, Alex, is doing. Did he book that Broadway show? I'm dying to know. He will update me.
Right, but these ads are coming at us every other scroll down, and it's pissing my ass off, you bitch.
If you're gonna invade our feed, at least be better than this Yapo ad. Look at this disaster. Ugh.
This fella looks like he tried to pledge a fraternity but lost his way during Hell Week.
Ugh.
I'm sorry, Yapo, but I'm reading and rereading this ad and I still don't know, Po, what it is you're selling.
Good. Yeah, before you boast about your 5,000 reviews, maybe let us in on who you are.
We don't know Jake Passan. We don't know MVMT watches. And we don't know you.
Now let's move on to the most nefarious evil in this rat king of evil, attractive females peddling tea. Let's examine Fit Tea and Ass.
Baby, I love butts. This one really takes the cake, pun intended, like an ass made of cake.
There's no better salesperson than a big booty Judy. These girls let their asses do the talking, and spoiler alert,
I'm listening with my little putt out.
I had an eating disorder for 6 years.
We're here with the effortlessly cool Jimmy O Yang. You can find him on all his social media handles at Funny Asian Dude. And he is a funny Asian dude, but was he always a funny Asian dude? I guess we're about to find out when we dive into your old Instagram posts in a little segment we like to call Defend or Delete.
We have this first post here.
Got my SAG card in the mail today. Now waiting for my V card to arrive.
Hashtag acting, hashtag SAG.
Wow.
Yo, okay. The post, I got no problem with the post, but the hashtag is sad as fuck. Like, I hate people when they do hashtag set life. Hashtag acting is so whack.
Yeah, do you think a lot of people are searching hashtag acting?
Yeah, when they're looking for actors, you know?
Well,
yeah.
No, casting directors do.
Yeah, that's what they told me.
This is crazy, I saw Steven Spielberg on a laptop at a coffee shop, and I like kind of creeped behind him, and I was like, what's he looking at? He was on Twitter and Instagram at the same time, just looking at hashtag actor, hashtag set life, hashtag SAG, and was casting.
That's how you found me.
On these hashtags.
Yeah.
Please block. No,
I
don't want to be involved.
I want to do a hashtag set life, guys. Huh? See? I missed that. Hey, hang on.
I just had to get my genitals out for it to get likes.
Good, see? We're gonna get so many followers from the hashtag set life.
Next, I just joined the hashtag dark side.
Wow. Wait, this is on my Instagram?
Yeah, that's you. Oh my god, Jimmy, you really threw down and you bought an iPad. Whoa.
On February 5th, 2013, Jimmy O Yang bought an iPad.
Ooh, it's dark. Oh my god.
You gotta understand how poor I was when it was 2013, and this was like a milestone in my life.
Ooh, you know what? Some people are good, and some people are bad to the f***ing bone, and they don't have keyboards.
2013, you got an iPad. You joined SAG.
Whoa. That was a big year for you, Jimmy.
That's a big year for you, Jimmy.
It was a big year.
Are you gonna defend or delete this?
I feel like it's so bad, and now people will see it on the show. I don't know if anybody watches the show, but if they do see it on the show, then I'm gonna look like an idiot deleting this, like, oh, I'm ashamed of it. So I might as well just like live with it and like be proud of it.
You guys at home, I want you to find this post on Instagram and like it and tell Jimmy you're with him on the dark side, honey, okay? Thank you so much, Jimmy, for coming in today. This was so much fun. We've learned a lot about you and your stupid little brain.
I really thought there were some good photos in there, and I think you're a really cool guy, and I think there's a lot of cool things that you are going to show us in the future.
I can't wait to see what you do, you idiot. We'll be right back.
I love each and every one of you so much. I know that this time is a hard time to live in, but just keep going. Wake up every day. Say, I'm going to do something that makes me happy, even if it's one little act of kindness to yourself. Do that for me. If you do that for anyone else, do it for me. I grew up a Christian, and even though I don't necessarily identify as a Christian anymore, I think that spirituality is important, and I hope you do too. Thanks for watching Unsend. Joel, don't come in that.